The topic I want to talk about today had to do with the declaration and the tagging of IPOB, Indigenous People of Biafra, one of the organizations that is leading the struggle for the actualization of the sovereignty of the Biafran state. The IPOB under Nnamdi Kanu and the Radio Biafra, London, have been the biggest organization in the struggle for the restoration of the sovereignty of the Biafran state. There are other organizations, but presently Radio Biafra and the IPOB under Nnamdi Kanu have been in the forefront, have been the loudest in this actualization for our independence and the restoration of our suspended sovereignty, which took place in 1970. But before I proceed to these laughable events, I want to point out something very sinister and important. There's a design to divide Biafrans against each other and to put a confusion amongst Biafrans. I don't know how many IPOB members have been approached. I don't know. I received a call 2 days ago from a very close confidant of mine, and he told me, he said I should speak to another very close confidant of mine, and I spoke to that other confidant of mine, and he said, "Ah, President, things they happen, no things they." And I said, "What is happening?" He said, "All other people have been contacted. I don't want to call names, because I don't know the level of their involvement, and I don't want to pry into what they do. But I want to warn us that there's a plan by the APC government, led by General Muhammadu Buhari, whether it's the one here or whoever they brought, or is a cabal. But there's a plan that is already afloat, that all the militants in Niger Delta have been recruited, and that they are pleading that I too should be involved. They are pleading with them that the militants have told them that I, Alhaji Mujahid Dokwasare, is not an issue in Niger Delta struggle any longer. I just talk, that I am incapable of doing anything. So they shouldn't bother, they should deal with them. That they know my what." These are his words. "They know my what. And for that purpose, he has pleaded with them to hide me, that there's a lot of money, up to 50 billion naira, that have been earmarked for this project, that they do not want Niger Deltans to support the struggle, especially the Jaws, because all the people he called, all the names mentioned, were Ijaw people. And most of them are part of the amnesty program. They have all keyed into the program, according to him. How true it is, I don't know, but I must warn us that, look, it's two of us that are really needed, just two of us, myself and one other person. That is what those at the top believe, that really have authority to influence people. That I can influence people internationally, that what I say has been disturbing them in Abuja, they are disturbed. That if I fail to be part of this grand design to divide the Jaws or the so-called Niger Deltans, with to divide the Jaws and the Igbos, then they will affect my arrest. And when they arrest me, this time I will not come out alive. And I thanked him. I said, look, I'm 53. These are my words. I'm 53 years old. My mother died before she was 40. My father died before he was 70. So I'm 53. I'm midway. So if I die now, nothing. He said, no, President, you will not die. In Jesus' name, you will not die. And I told him that sort of flattery does not work me, does not do anything for me, does not move me, because I'm certainly going to die. If I don't die today, I will die tomorrow. But I want to die standing, and I want to die fighting. I don't want to die on my knees. A lot of times these bribes have come up. Before Yar'Adua, Obasanjo attempted to bribe me with several things. It's alive. And if he's sincere with himself, because of me, Obasanjo created the Department of Youth, Women, Sports in NDDC. And in front of elders, including E.K. Clark and others, Obasanjo offered that I should become the first director of the Youth, Women's, Culture and Sports Directorate of NDDC. And I told him I was not interested. And so many of the people who are close to me said I should nominate them. And I told them, I can't nominate you. If I reject something I don't want, how can I nominate you? If I nominate you, then I'm the person that had accepted it. It brought quarrel between me and my associates, between me and my followers, and some of them left me because they said I was too rigid. After that, during Yar'Adua time, Yar'Adua did a lot of things for me. And Yar'Adua wanted me to take the amnesty program. When I refused, he arrested me. Luckily, it was when the president of Russia was visiting, and foreign journalists asked the question, you are declaring amnesty and you are arresting some people. That was how the SSS in Lagos released me, and I left. And I went into self-exile. When Goodluck Jonathan came, he's alive. Yar'Adua is dead. Goodluck Jonathan called me, even before I arrived, that I should come and take the amnesty. It will be very fulfilled if I take the amnesty. Any number of people I want to declare that I should come and take the amnesty, Timia Libby, everybody was on my neck. Come and take the amnesty. You are the only person who has not taken the amnesty. And I told them, if Ijaw people are taking amnesty for being Ijaw people, then you people should also take the amnesty. I'm a former president of the Ijaw Youth Council. I told former President Goodluck Jonathan, I have told Timia Libby, that you people should also take the amnesty. Because if the amnesty is for Ijaw people, every Ijaw person should be a militant and should take amnesty. Then, as former president of the Ijaw Youth Council, I don't know how I became a militant, but I should be given amnesty. So I refuse to take the amnesty. The amnesty has created billionaires, has created people who have gotten money, a lot of money, have made. I rejected the amnesty. Amnesty has trained so many people, even those who are very close to me. The amnesty program has trained so many people and affected the life of so many people. I turned around the life of those who really want to use the program for their good, have turned their life around. That's the truth. But should the people of Niger Delta be subjected to a criminal tag simply because they want to go to school, simply because they want to acquire skills, and so they should be criminalized, they should be called names? And then a lot of people who took their amnesty, we're just petty criminals on the street. We're cultists, we're gangsters. And they took the amnesty, they become rich, they inflated the number of people on the list, and so on and so forth. But it's their money, the money from there. Anybody who chooses to be criminalized to take amnesty will take. But this is very dangerous. The danger in this is that it wants to divide The fear is that a lot of Niger Delta combatants are favorably disposed. That's what my friend said. That the ASS has discovered that overwhelming majority of Niger Delta combatants are favorably disposed towards Biafra. That if there is an open conflict, majority of our people are going to side with Biafra. They will join Biafra and fight Nigeria. And that is very dangerous because they are depending on the job people. They don't want to antagonize the job people. And my friend said, you are one of the key people. We don't want you to die. We don't want you to be arrested. You have to join that. There's this thing that Nnamdi Kanu is being shielded by my people somewhere in the creeks of the Niger Delta in the battle stand of River State. And I feel, and I told him how, he said that's the belief, that the DSS has concrete evidence that Nnamdi Kanu is being shielded by my people somewhere in River State, in the creeks of the Niger Delta, in the battle towns of River State, that the SSS is sure that I was at Umoja when Nnamdi Kanu's house was raided, that I was at Umoja, and we sneaked Nnamdi Kanu out, and they called some very close people to me who are with Nnamdi Kanu. They called some very close people to me. Yes, those individuals are close to me. They said this individual are Niger Delta Freedom, Niger Delta Volunteer Force, and Niger Delta People Salvation Front commanders. They know them. They are always with me. And they are in BSS. And these people had smuggled Nnamdi Kanu out. In fact, there's a particular one they said, he quoted that at so time, the guy was with me in my car and we traveled to so place, so they know him very well. He even featured on the video of DSS. I said, but you are with, the person you are with know these people you are talking. So it might be the person giving you information. Yes. Everybody is free. I am a Biafran. Majority of my followers, those who believe in me, also accepted being Biafrans. And they are ready to lay down their life for Biafran. There's no doubt about it. But that they took Nnamdi Kanu to the creeks of Niger Delta is the fragment of the imagination of any other people. But if we have, I want to say, if we have the opportunity to take Nnamdi Kanu to anywhere, even to my house, to keep him, I will do it. But it is not true that he's in my house. It's not true that he's been shielded somewhere that I know. It's not true. But if I have the opportunity, and Nnamdi Kanu confide in me that I should take him, and I know where to keep him, I will take him and keep him, because I believe that Nnamdi Kanu is one of the pillars of the struggle for the restoration of the sovereignty of the Biafran state. Having said that, I think the Nigerian state had shot itself on the foot, on their right foot. The Nigerian, when these nonsensical declaration of IPOB as a terrorist organization came up, there was jubilation in the APC camp and in the camps of the Efulefus. They were saying that IPOB had been declared. In fact, yesterday I engaged somebody on Facebook and I told him, there is scam. It would be very stupid for anybody to think that Buhari can defeat IPOB or the Biafran struggle. Very stupid. All over the world, there are demonstrations. India, Russia, Japan, Turkey, London, Paris, Switzerland, Germany, different cities of Germany. My family also participated in the demonstration in Hamburg, in Frankfurt. There are people, members of my family. So there are demonstrations for Biafra everywhere, all over the world. And somebody is deceiving himself, thinking that Biafra had been defeated. Now, the United States of America, Britain, EU, and France have come out that they do not believe that IPOB, they do not accept that IPOB is a terrorist organization. That's the first victory. Nigeria, they're peeing in their pants. Buhari is peeing in his pants. He's dripping. Lai Mohammed is, even his pampas can no longer hold his pee. Even Lai Mohammed pampas cannot hold his pee. They are peeing because they know that they have lost round one. Nnamdi Kanu has given them a knockout in this first bout. And it's a victory, and all of us must acknowledge it. And people say, you follow Nnamdi Kanu, you are now following Nnamdi Kanu. Well, what is wrong if I follow Nnamdi Kanu? If Nnamdi Kanu is doing better than me in actualizing Biafra, what is wrong in me following him? Should it be me? Should it be about myself? The freedom of my people is not about myself. The freedom of my people is my freedom and the freedom of all Biafrans. And if Nnamdi Kanu is doing it better than me, I should be able to acknowledge the fact that he's doing it better than me. I am not a member of Nnamdi Kanu IPOB. But if Nnamdi Kanu IPOB is doing it better than my platform, then I should be able. Because it's not about me. It's not about myself. So round one, oh, Nigeria. Nnamdi Kanu, I'm giving you people KO. Knockout. IPOB is not a terrorist organization. The world has acclaimed. The president of the Senate has acclaimed. Members of House of Representatives from the West, from the Southwest, from the South-South-Southeast has come out. The Joint Youth Council, as bad as it is today, has come out. The Joint National Congress and Afenefere, all are unanimous in saying IPOB is not a terrorist organization. I expected, you can call us anything. I expected that we can be a terrorist organization. You can call up terrorists. You, if you are killing our people without anything, without any qualms, you kill our people. You kill defenseless, harmless people. You receive scrap armored vehicle, APCs from Jordan so that you can use it to crush our people. If it cannot shoot, it will crush our people. It's mental to kill our people. If you are doing all that, there's nothing you can do. Calling us terrorist organization is the least of the things that I expected from you that you will do. But we thank God that as bad as it is, the world is unanimous in saying that IPOB is not a terrorist organization.